Hello to class 9 students. Class 9 students, in our last class we were doing importance of commerce and we were doing actually the hindrances that commerce removes. In your books there must be hindrances that commerce remove. There is no such straight points given to you, but under the importance to commerce there are certain hindrances which are given there, and these hindrances are which are removed by commerce are only the importance of commerce, right? So in our last class we did two hindrances, and that were hindrance of person and hindrance of place. First we did hindrance of person. Just to revise in short, hindrance of person was that commerce remove the problem of contact between the producer and consumer. Usually producer sits at a different place and consumer sits at a different place, and producer has to look for the customers, for the category of customers he has, and customers or consumers has to look for the producers, those who are going to supply goods for them. But this is a problem. There is no such direct contact between these two, but with the help of commerce, this problem is removed, because commerce removes this hindrance by creating a link between producer and consumer, right? Commerce creates what? Commerce creates a link between producer and consumer, right? It creates a link between them. Trade establish a contact between producer. And who under commerce do this? Trade. Trade under commerce remove this hindrance. So this is going to be a first importance of commerce, which we did in our last class. And the next importance of commerce is hindrance of place. Hindrance of place. Now what is hindrance of place? I told you that commerce removes the hindrance by moving goods from place of production to the place of consumption. Now the place for the production is entirely different. The production takes place at entirely different place, and producer has to somehow bring those product to the reach of the customers, reach of the consumers. And this problem, this hindrance of place, is solved by commerce again, because under this problem, because by moving goods from the place production to the places of consumption through various modes of transport. So through commerce, again, under commerce, you have trade or transport also, and through the help of transport, with the help of transport, the producers are able to send their product to the ultimate buyer. So this is what two points we did in our last class. So we are going to proceed with another point today, and that is hindrance of time. So third importance is the hindrance of time. Commerce removes the hindrance by holding and preserving goods in warehouse. Hindrance of time. Now when the producer produce product, they don't directly sell it to the customers. When they produce product, they have to keep this a large stock of this product in godowns, in warehouses, where they are kept safely and in good conditions. And whenever there is demand for the product, these product from the warehouse, from the godowns, they are sent to the ultimate consumers through the retailers and market. Now, hindrance of time means that with the help of trade, with the help of commerce, in which you have warehousing and storage, the products which are produced by the producer are kept in the godowns, in the warehouses, which again is a part of commerce, and at the right time, at the right place, these products are picked up from the godowns and warehouses and sent to the ultimate buyer. So this is again the third importance. In this commerce, in this holding and preserving goods in warehouse until they are sold to consumers. Holding and preserving goods in the warehouse until they are sold. Right? So if I explain you this third point, they are explaining you that जब भी कोई प्रोडक्ट्स बनते हैं फैक्ट्रीज में या इंडस्ट्रीज में, उनको डायरेक्टली बेचा नहीं जाता है, क्योंकि वो एक साथ ही बहुत सारे प्रोडक्ट्स बनते हैं, तो पहले इन प्रोडक्ट्स को गोदाम में या वेयर हाउसेज में रखना पड़ता है, और इन प्रोडक्ट्स को जब जरूरत पड़ती है तो वहां से इनको बेच दिया जाता है, मार्केट भेजा जाता है, और रिटेलर्स की हेल्प से इनको अल्टीमेट कंज्यूमर्स तक, फाइनल कंज्यूमर्स तक पहुंचाया जाता है। और ये वेयर हाउसेज, ये गोडाउन और ये वेयर हाउसेज जो है जहाँ पे प्रोडक्ट्स को संभाल के रखा जाता है, ये भी कॉमर्स का पार्ट है। तो जो थर्ड चीज है जो कॉमर्स की इंपॉर्टेंस आती है, कॉमर्स की इंपॉर्टेंस है, वो ये है दैट हिंड्रेंस ऑफ टाइम इज रिमूव्ड बाय कॉमर्स। कॉमर्स में, कॉमर्स क्या करता है, टाइम यूटिलिटी जोड़ देता है प्रोडक्ट्स में, वो टाइम, सही टाइम पे सही प्रोडक्ट को सही कस्टमर तक पहुंचाने में मदद करता है विद द हेल्प ऑफ वेयर हाउसेज। द नेक्स्ट इज हिंड्रेंस ऑफ रिस्क। द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंस इज हिंड्रेंस ऑफ रिस्क। हिंड्रेंस ऑफ रिस्क, सी इसमें होता क्या है कि प्रोड्यूसर्स जो होते हैं दे बेयर रिस्क। ऑब्वियसली हर प्रोड्यूसर रिस्क लेता है, विदाउट रिस्क इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू डू प्रोडक्शन। हर प्रोड्यूसर रिस्क के तहत ही अपने काम करता है, लेकिन उनके जो रिस्क होते हैं वो इंश्योरेंस कंपनी बहुत हद तक क्या करती है, टैकल करती है। तभी बड़े बड़े प्रोड्यूसर्स जो होते हैं, चाहे छोटे प्रोड्यूसर्स होते हैं, वो लोग क्या कराते हैं, अपने प्रोडक्शन की, अपनी चीज़ों की क्या करा लेते हैं, इंश्योरेंस करा लेते हैं। बाई चांस किसी तरह कोई लॉस होता है, कोई डैमेज होता है, कोई एक्सीडेंटल डैमेजेस होते हैं, तो उस केस में इंश्योरेंस उसकी उनकी मदद करता है, और उनकी उनको क्या करता है, उनको वो उनका मुआवजा देता है। सो अगेन इंश्योरेंस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ कॉमर्स, एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ इंश्योरेंस कॉमर्स इज रिमूविंग द हिंड्रेंस ऑफ रिस्क विच ईच एंड एवरी प्रोड्यूसर बियर्स। सो अंडर दिस व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, कंज्यूमर कॉमर्स रिमूव्स द रिस्क ऑफ लॉस और डैमेज। कॉमर्स रिमूव द रिस्क ऑफ लॉस और लॉस और डैमेज बाय मीन्स ऑफ इंश्योरेंस, बाय मीन्स ऑफ इंश्योरेंस। ठीक है, अब कोई भी प्रोडक्ट है जब वो प्रोड्यूस कर लिया गया है तो शायद उस किसी भी तरह की कोई प्रॉब्लम आ सकती है, कि जिसकी वजह से आपका जो प्रोडक्शन करके जो स्टोरेज में रखा गया है वो शायद खराब हो जाए या डैमेज हो जाए, चाहे वो किसी नेचुरल कैलमिटी की वजह से हो, चाहे फायर लग जाए उसमें, चाहे उसमें अर्थक्वेक आ जाए या बाढ़ आ जाए, उसकी वजह से अगर आपका सामान खराब हो जाता है जो कि एक खतरा होता है, तो इसके इसके लिए क्या करते हैं, इसके लिए प्रोड्यूसर्स जो होते हैं अपने आप को इंश्योर करा लेते हैं, अपने अपना क्या लेते हैं, इंश्योरेंस ले लेते हैं, ताकि वो किसी भी तरह के लॉसेस को कवर कर सके। सो अगेन ये जो इंश्योरेंसेस होते हैं ये किसका पार्ट है, ये कॉमर्स का पार्ट है। सो जो थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंस है हिंड्रेंस ऑफ रिस्क, वो कॉमर्स क्या करता है, उसको टैकल करता है, और इसलिए वो इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ कॉमर्स कहलाता है। नाउ फिफ्थ, दिस वाज अ फोर्थ, नाउ फिफ्थ वन इज हिंड्रेंस ऑफ फाइनेंस। हिंड्रेंस ऑफ फाइनेंस, हिंड्रेंस का मतलब क्या होता है, हिंड्रेंस मतलब किसी तरह की कोई रुकावट। ठीक है, तो कॉमर्स इन रुकावटों को क्या कर रहा है, दूर कर रहा है। फाइनेंस का मतलब क्या होता है, फाइनेंस का मतलब होता है जितने भी पैसे की जरूरत आपको आपके प्रोडक्शन के दौरान प्रोड्यूसर्स को पड़ती है। नाउ कॉमर्स क्या करता है, कॉमर्स रिमूव द हिंड्रेंस बाय प्रोवाइडिंग फाइनेंस थ्रू बैंकिंग। नाउ कॉमर्स क्या कर रहा है यहाँ पे, जो नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंस है, कॉमर्स रिमूव इज रिमूव्स फाइनेंशियल प्रॉब्लम्स, फाइनेंशियल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ प्रोड्यूसर्स, प्रॉब्लम ऑफ प्रोड्यूसर्स थ्रू बैंकिंग, राइट। जितने भी पैसे की प्रॉब्लम है, जितने भी क्या है, फाइनेंस की प्रॉब्लम है, फाइनेंस मतलब पैसे की प्रॉब्लम है, ठीक है, पैसे की प्रॉब्लम है, जितने भी पैसे की प्रॉब्लम है, मनी प्रॉब्लम है, वो कौन करता है, बैंक्स दूर करते हैं। और बैंक्स किसका पार्ट है, अगेन बैंक्स इज द पार्ट ऑफ कॉमर्स, राइट। सो व्हेनेवर प्रोड्यूसर्स हैव सम प्रॉब्लम रिगार्डिंग मनी, दे कैन गो टू द बैंक एंड दे कैन गेट मनी फ्रॉम देयर। बाइंग एंड सेलिंग ऑफ गुड्स बिटवीन पर्सन्स लिविंग इन डिफरेंट प्लेस रिक्वायर्स अ कॉमन मीडियम ऑफ पेमेंट। मनी सर्व्स एज अ कॉमन मीडियम ऑफ पेमेंट, However, convenient and safe means of payment are required to settle these transactions. तो किसी भी तरह का कोई पैसा अगर चाहे वो पेमेंट करना है, पेमेंट लेना है, प्रोड्यूसर को, प्रोड्यूसर ने किसी को देना है या प्रोड्यूसर ने नई फैक्ट्री लेनी है या प्रोड्यूसर ने मशीन लेनी है, अगर उसको कोई प्रॉब्लम हो रहा है पैसे का तो वो क्या कर सकता है, वो बैंक की मदद ले सकता है और बैंक फिर से क्या है, कॉमर्स का ही हिस्सा है. बैंक हेल्प टू रिमूव दिस ऑब्स्टिकल इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सचेंज or by making the collective payment on behalf of their clients. New businessmen can send money from one place to another in the form of bank draft, check. तो लोग क्या करते हैं आजकल bank draft का इस्तेमाल करते हैं, checks का इस्तेमाल किया जाता है, या आप बोल सकते हो online transactions होती है, online banking के through. तो ये सारी चीज जो आजकल के प्रोड्यूसर्स और कंज्यूमर्स आजकल के डील करते हैं, इन तरीकों से डील करते हैं, ये सारी की सारी हेल्प, हु इज गोइंग टू हेल्प देम. सो द बैंकिंग सिस्टम व्हिच इज अगेन द पार्ट ऑफ द कॉमर्स हेल्प देम टू रिमूव दिस हिंड्रेंस. सो दिस इज हाउ द फाइनेंस प्रॉब्लम और द ऑब्स्टिकल ऑफ फाइनेंस इज रिमूव बाय द बैंकिंग व्हिच इज द पार्ट ऑफ कॉमर्स. सो चिल्ड्रन, द नेक्स्ट इज hindrance of knowledge. The sixth importance is hindrance of knowledge. Sixth importance is now see, producer needs to give information to their clients, to their customers. Without information, the consumers would not know about the product which the producer is selling, and they would not come to know about the features of the product. So it becomes very, very important for the producer to give required knowledge to the customers, and with the help of advertisements, customers are given information regarding the product. Commerce through advertisements help the problem of producers as well as customers, because advertisements are the part of commerce, and they again provide required knowledge, correct knowledge about the product, about the market, about the prices to the customers, and customers come to know about the product. So this is the problem which is faced by the people and the producer also, the customer and the producer also. So producer, with the help of advertisements, remove this hindrance. So children, all together, if we see, just we'll make a short revision. If you talk about the importance of commerce, so importance of commerce mein hum dekhenge that there are several branch. If we see commerce, we'll see the different branches commerce has, right? And the way commerce is helping, right? So commerce, write it with blue pen to make it more visible to people. Trade, right? With the help of trade, what happens with the help of trade? Hindrance of person is removed, right? Now we talk about hindrance of place. Hindrance of place may we are going to put transportation this is your transportation. Then Under hindrance of time, we are going to write down warehouses. You can say storage also. Right? This is the third thing that commerce is doing. Then under risk, you have insurance. Commerce, insurance is also the branch of commerce. It also helps this. Then finance, that we talk about finance, these could be banking is also it provides finance. Finance means required money of the producers, and next is, and last is the advertisement. Advertisement, right? So if we see this small type of small diagram, it becomes quite visible and clear to us that what is the importance of commerce. So just in a short way, in a short note, I'm going to complete this. We are reading importance of commerce. You have commerce first. So commerce has so many branches, and under through these branches only we are going to read about the different hindrances which are removed, right? Now, as far as trade is concerned, trade removes our hindrance of, here it removes hindrance of person. This is your hindrance of place. This is hindrance of time, hindrance of risk, here hindrance of finance, hindrance of finance, and this is last, hindrance of information, right? Knowledge, you can also say knowledge. So these are the different hindrances which are removed by commerce, different branches of commerce, and this makes work more smoother between the producer as well as the customers. Alright students, so further, so now students, after this we are going to do, the next topic is going to be that next topic we are going to do will be types of branches of commerce. Branches of commerce. So children, will do types and branches of commerce. Here we have trade. Now they will say we are talking about trade. But what is trade? So children, trade is your buying and selling of goods, right? This trade facilitates buying and selling of goods, right? Jo bhi goods ban rahe hain unko bechna aur unko khareedna, ye jo dono ka dono process hai, this is known as trade. Now and further we can say that trade is nucleus of commerce. So jo commerce hai, if this is commerce, iska jo nucleus hai wo kya hai? Trade hai. Matlab without trade there is no commerce, without trade there is no commerce, right children? So without trade we cannot, trade is a very very important part of very very important part of commerce. So without trade nothing is possible. Now if we talk about trade, so trade can be divided into two, domestic trade and foreign trade. So trade, I told you, as earlier I told you that trade kya hai, buying and selling of goods ko hum trade kehte hain. So trade can be divided into two parts, foreign trade and domestic trade. Foreign trade and domestic trade. Now, what is foreign trade? Now, external trade refers to buying and selling of goods and services between different countries. This trade, ये जो trade होता है, ये जो व्यापार होता है, ये different countries के बीच में होता है. Different countries के बीच में जो trade होगा, वो आपका क्या है? Foreign trade है. Whereas जो domestic trade है, this is the internal trade. This is the internal trade within the boundary of a country. So, एक country के अंदर ही अंदर जो trade होता है, जिसे हम घरेलू trade भी कहते हैं in Hindi. So, this is your domestic trade. So, again I am telling you, so trade can be divided into two types. If we talk about the types of trade, तो trade को हम दो जो मोटा मोटा type है वो कर सकते हैं, foreign trade and domestic trade. Foreign trade is what? This is also known as external trade. Foreign trade is also known as external trade. External trade refers to buying and selling of goods and services between different countries. In this trade, the seller and buyer belong to different countries. यहाँ पे जो क्या होंगे, buyer और seller अलग-अलग countries के होंगे. Whereas जो domestic trade होगा या घरेलू trade होगा, इसमें जो buyer और जो sellers हैं, ये एक ही country के होंगे. So in our next class, I am going to tell you in detail about the foreign trade and domestic trade. These are the two type of trade. So again, summing up, again we'll repeat what is trade. Trade is buying and selling of goods. Now we buy and sell goods in two levels. Well, first is your domestic trade, that is internal trade, which is done within the country, within the boundaries of a country. And the another type of trade is international trade or external trade or foreign trade, which is done between the countries. Here the customers and buyers belongs to different countries, right? So again, it has more of details which we will do tomorrow. And the homework for you today is this, that you people are going to prepare your notes in your FAIR notebooks up to the point where I have teach you. So soon, tomorrow we'll be meeting in our next video. Till then, take care and stay at home. Okay, children.